So I'm going to say good afternoon right now, and I'm going to thank you again. We all have to look and see now, do we have lettuce in our teeth or anything, because it's after lunchtime. But we're still on the case of things to know about right now while coronavirus is out and about with us. Not really liking the statistics that are coming across, but we'll live with them. And we're doing the very best we can to bring information to all of you on things that we think are important to know right now, that if you have an issue today's, for instance, we're going to talk about rehabilitation, but we're going to talk about rehabilitation facilities, not just rehabilitation. So stay tuned, because there are some differences here. When we do talk about rehabilitation, so I did this last night, and it said simple rehabilitation is restoring someone to health through training and therapy. And that's part of what we want to talk about. But we have with us today Josh Bowie, who is the CEO of Vibra Rehabilitation Hospital in Rancho Mirage. And so what I want to ask him for you is, what is the difference between a rehab facility and a rehabilitation hospital? So if you've gotten to some of the videos that we've done earlier, we talk about the 3-day or the 3-midnight rule in a hospital before going over to a rehab center. So there's some overlapping information that's going to happen here, but let's get started with it. So Josh, thank you so much for coming on board with us today, for taking, I know you have a hugely busy schedule, so really, really thank you for that.
Well, no, I appreciate you having me, and again, in these uncertain times, I appreciate the opportunity to be able to convey as much information as we know, obviously being on a lot of phone calls, seeing a lot of things out today. And so it's real important that we be able to share that information with everyone.
Well, so I think my first question is, we're talking about essential business and non-essential businesses, at least in the county of Riverside right now. So are you open right now? Are you able to take patients? That would be my first question.
We are absolutely open, and we are, of course, hoping that we do not see an anticipated surge in any patient population, whether it's rehabilitative or in the acute care setting. But we are preparing, and that's the important part, is that the healthcare system here in the Valley is prepared, and we're doing everything possible to be there for the community at this time.
Truly, as a county, I think we've done an incredible job of, our statistics seem to be so much higher than many other small communities. We have so many more deaths right now, et cetera. But we don't want to really go there. We're not covering COVID right now. We're going to cover rehabilitation. So can you describe to our audience the different types of rehabilitation? I said earlier, a rehabilitation center, rehabilitation hospital. What is that difference?
So I think there's really two distinct differences, and that's in what we're talking about, a center or a facility versus a hospital. So in a rehabilitation hospital, we have to meet certain regulatory guidelines that are different than a rehab center or a skilled nursing facility. The rehab itself might be very similar. It's going to be the amount of rehab that you're going to receive that is going to be kind of a huge difference in the distinction between the two types of facilities. And in a rehab hospital, we have to, by regulatory standards, we have to meet what's called a 15-hour rule. So you basically have to have 3 hours of therapy over 5 days. If there's a need, we can spread that over a 7-day period, but the reality is what we really, from appropriate patient standpoint, we want to be able to get those 3 hours done in 5 consecutive days. So that's where the big major difference in the rehab piece of between a hospital and a center. The center is between 4 to 5 minutes to 1 hour. Does not mean that they will not provide more. That is what they are regulated and what they're mandated to do in order to meet their guidelines. So that's where the real big difference is the amount of the therapy. The therapy itself, from an occupational rehab standpoint, physical therapy or speech, they have all the same modalities and disciplines. It's just the amount of therapy that they can dedicate to that. And that is the major difference from a therapy standpoint. From a hospital standpoint, we, as being part of the California Hospital Association, we have to have nurses, and those nurses can't have more than five patients. So so the level or intensity of the care, the medical care, is just different, as well as we are mandated to have daily physician visits, as well as daily physician visits from our PM&R, physical medicine rehabilitation. So the therapy is the same, it's the intensity, and then we just have a more complex, higher medical structure here at the hospital.
Yeah, I think the supervisory capacity that you just talked about, having the physician and the nurses, et cetera, is much different than what I know of as a rehab facility. Yeah. So good to know. But this, so now we talk about the, so patients who typically come from the hospital can go into a rehab facility and have it covered by Medicare, if they are Medicare eligible, after spending three midnights in a hospital. So the, because you are considered a hospital, can a person come to you directly off the street, essentially?
Yes, they can. Now, that way, they do need a physician referral, typically, the meaning they can go to their primary care physician. They could also be on home health. They could be in an outpatient therapy center. They can recommend to us that they can be admitted directly from the home setting. So we will physically, in those situations that we get a referral, we will physically go out and send one of our nurse liaisons out to the home to do an evaluation and to ensure that this level of care would be the appropriate level of care for that patient.
And so at that point, then it would be covered by Medicare. I mean, they don't have to go into a different hospital and then come out to you.
That is correct. So we do not, the 3-hour rule only, or the, excuse me, the 3-day midnight rule only applies to skilled nursing facilities, not rehab hospitals. We can take directly from the ER, the emergency room, the observation unit, or the hospital directly, or even the home admission, as we just talked about.
That is so incredibly important, especially for our local people who know where your hospital is located in Rancho Mirage, because until Vibra came along, we didn't have that facility or that opportunity down here. And so everybody kind of had to go to the hospital first, do their three midnights, and then go out to a skilled nursing facility. I knew that, but I'm happy that you explained that to our group. So further than that, you talked earlier about speech therapy, occupational therapy, and physical therapy. Do by any chance, does Vibra have LSVT loud clinicians or LSVT big clinicians? We haven't covered those in videos yet, but we'll get there. Do you have those on staff?
Well, I'm actually really excited to share that we do. So matter of fact, a series of our, we have six of our therapists that have went through and now are certified in both those scenarios. So we're very excited about that. Now we do wish that we had an outpatient program that we could continue that. And the LOUD program has been shown to work the best in a multiple month over program. But we are able to be able to provide that, even though in a short 2-week period of their stay, we are able to start to explore some of those same concepts. And our therapists, matter of fact, are doing that on multiple groups and diagnoses through that we're finding that the patient population is really seeking. So unfortunately, we don't have in the outpatient, but in the inpatient, we do.
I'm so happy to hear that. But Josh, I'll tell you, I will work with you directly if necessary to help get that outpatient thing done, because we really need that those services here in the Valley. So call on me when we get a chance to do that. Okay. So then we've covered that. And is there anything particular that's going on because we're in COVID-19 right now that you're noticing at the hospital that we might want to draw the attention to of somebody listening?
I think the most part is to let everybody know out there that we're all in the same boat together, that our Healthcare workers are out here on the front line. They have families and members that are being affected both economically and from a health crisis situation. So really just encouraged to let everybody know that we are working every single day in an emergency management situation here locally. There's many cases that you're seeing from both Eisenhower. There's a great article from their CEO regarding their what they just had to drive for the ventilators. There's just some amazing messages of hope out there. And what I want to encourage everybody to know that we are preparing and we are prepared to do everything we can on the front lines of this unfortunate crisis. We just continue to encourage people to stay home, stay healthy, and to kind of bear with us as we kind of navigate this really unprecedented situation.
Yeah, we're all navigating, aren't we? Yeah. So, I will give my pride in a minute here, but as I understand, Vibra is located in about 14 other states. Is that so?
We are, and that has been interesting to watch. And California has been kind of on the forefront. So I will tell you, many of the things that we're experiencing, we've been able to share with our colleagues in other counties and other states. And so that's the benefit of being really a national company.
Super. So what we want to do with you at some point in time is get them in the Wellness Village too, so people from other states can find them, because we're, as of a couple of weeks, we've been around the world for a long time, but this one is really, we're really zeroing in on the needs of our constituents. I want to thank you and Vibra for being the hosts of our support group, our physical support group meetings, which are currently on COVID-19 recess, if you will. We won't be coming out and having support group meetings there, but the last one that we had, I think we had 67 people in that little room. And we also had someone that experienced being in Vibra there to tell us the magnificence of what they went through, the support that they felt, and how they rehabilitated in that 2-week period of time. It was just a really nice story to hear. So I'm going to say to all of you at the audience, now you know something else. There are rehabilitation centers. There are rehabilitation hospitals. We happen to be talking right now to the CEO of a hospital. And for further information on Vibra, you can go to the Wellness Village on our website, parkinsonsresource.org, and click on them and get more information, because you can go directly through to their website. And Josh has done a wonderful job of giving up some time today. So I just want to tell you, thank you so much for answering some questions, being there, that we know you're there, and we'll be in close touch.
We appreciate it. You guys be well, okay?
You too. Now go wash your hands.
Absolutely.